When's it going to stop?
That's the most important question. That's the most important question. And that's what drives me crazy, Jenna, when we hear people taking an incident like this in which we lost the life of a young woman who should, by all accounts, still be here with us today, that injured 14 other people. And you have people who would love to exploit their pain, our pain for a community, to grind an axe on politics instead of focusing on the question, when and what's it really gonna take for it to stop? If all we're doing is chasing people after there's guns all in our community and saying, how do we get them out? Then we're gonna keep chasing our tail. We need help and we need work. We need intervention at the state level and at the federal level to say, we can actually create policy that slows the tide of illegal guns in our communities.
Do you ever just get angry?
Carrying the weight of everything that happens in our community is really heavy. And yes, like, you have to be angry. How can you not be angry about something like that to happen? Our police officers in St. Paul did exactly what we expect them to, exactly what we hope them that they'll do, and they did it very well. Our police officers, our firefighters, our paramedics showed up on the scene right away. And I'll tell you, I'm offended on their behalf when people want to pretend that this happened because of something they were unable or unwilling or weren't able to do. And this is a cycle that our country and our city has been in for generations. I remember being in junior high school and waking up and wondering what that hole in the wall above my bed was, and finding out later that it was a bullet hole. You know, when we build a public safety system that's just focused on locking people up as quickly as possible and for as long as possible after they fire a gun in our communities, well, that's unsatisfactory. That's not good enough, which is why we need a much broader, much more comprehensive system than we've ever endeavored.
What is this saying to us as people? What is this saying to us?
There's an enormous amount of not only research, but common sense that just says that untreated trauma, unprocessed trauma, echoes in the form of more trauma.
Do you think you and the chief are on the same page on that?
I think the chief is a strong public leader whose job is to lead a police department. Our job is to lead an entire community.
Have we just become, again, used to this?
I don't think we've become used to it. I haven't become used to it. And I know there is a significant amount of outrage and frustration and anger. I do think that there are people who are saying, you know, I'm tired of lighting candles.
Mm-hmm. I'm tired ready. I'm tired of thoughts and prayers.
I'm ready to move some legislation. I'm ready to move some policy. We can't just light a candle and, you know, hold hands and then move on with our lives, because what that gets us is more of the same. When our federal laws and our state laws make it easy for guns to flow into and through our community, when those are the case, and what we have access to do at the local level is to respond after the federal laws and state laws have already made it easy for guns to flow into our community and throughout our community, then the challenge that we give to our police officers, the challenge that we give to our police chief, the challenge that we give to our law enforcement community is really a daunting challenge. We have to figure out how to get further upstream of that. Every location in our city is special. It's not supposed to happen anywhere. It's not supposed to happen anywhere at all. What strikes me sometimes when I hear folks talk as though gun violence is new, and I think about the cousin that my father lost when he was 25. When I think about the cousin of mine who was killed on Selby Avenue when I was in elementary school. When I think about all the different experiences that I've had throughout my life, is that for some reason, those folks who feel like all of a sudden this is a problem in our community have not been paying attention for the last 20, 40, 80 years in our community.